Welcome to my channel Programming with Nitin. In this video, we are going to make an online quiz using Google Form. Okay? So first of all, you have to click on the Google Chrome icon. Now, this kind of screen will come in your mobile. Now you have to click on the search bar and you have to write here Google Forms. A new window will open. Now in this window you have to click on the Google Forms. A next window will open. In this window you have to click on the Go to Google Forms. Now it will ask you that from which account you will want to make your Google form. So if you want to make your Google form from the given account, so you have to click on that account. And if you want to make a Google form from a new or another account, you have to click on the use another account. I am using use another account. Okay. And now I am entering my account ID. Now click on the next. After this, I am entering the password. After entering the password, a new Google form will open. After this, what you have to do? First of all, you have to click on the untitled form. Type the name by which you can identify your form for the next time when you want to edit your form or see your form. Okay, so I am typing here hardware quiz. Okay, now click on the three dots given here near to the profile picture. A menu will open from which you have to click on the settings. After click on the settings, you will see general presentation and arrow. You have to click on the arrow. Next tab will visible after clicking on the arrow. So you have to click on the quizzes. Now you have to click on this option, make this a quiz. Okay, so now it will give you options to make a quiz immediately after each submission. Release grade. If you want to display the grade of a child to the child screen, so you have to select immediately after each submission, or later after manual review. Turns on email collection, so you will select immediately after each submission. Okay, now respondent can see missed question, correct answer, point values. Okay, now after doing this you have to click on the save. Okay, so see, now here the total points option is showing by the Google Forms. Okay, now this form is open for you, that how many questions you want to insert in your quiz. Okay, like I am inserting my first question. Select input device name from given below. Okay, now you have to click on the multiple choice. Option 1 RAM, option 2 ROM, click on add option, mouse, add option, CPU. Okay, Now click on the tick option to select the correct option from the given options. So my mouse is the correct option, and you have to give here the point of the question, like 5 points or 1 point. Okay, done. So now your question, one question is ready in your quiz. Now to add another question, what you have to do, you have to click on the plus option from the below given bar, like this plus option. So now you can see 3 questions are there in my quiz, and I have to insert 2 more questions now. Okay, and one more thing, you have to make all questions required. So the person will not submit the form till the any one of the question is not attended by them. Okay, so meaning is that he or she has to fill up full form with right or wrong options. After that the form will submit. Okay, next is my in computer storage device is CPU, ROM, RAM, hard disk. Now click on the tick option, select the correct option, give the point, and done. Okay, now second question is also ready for the quiz. Now third question, what is the full form of RAM? Random access memory, run according memory. Okay, now click on the tick option, select the right one, give the point, and done. Okay, so now 3 questions in my quiz. Now it is showing total 3 points. Okay, after this your form is automatically saving on your Google Drive is connected to your Gmail account. So whatever Gmail account you are using here, same Gmail account you have to use on your Google Drive, by which you can access your form again and again. Like I am showing you, after closing this form, okay, now it is closed. Go to Google Drive. See, the form is there. Okay, so now if you want to open or share this form to anyone, like this, you can share this form from here. Okay, link share, you have to make on the link sharing, and now share from the pupil you want. Okay, if you click on it, it will open in the web browser again. Okay, now suppose from another email ID I am using this Google form, okay, so now I am So now what actually I am doing, I am giving this quiz or attempting this quiz, and I am filling this quiz because now I am logging with my another Gmail account. Okay, so now I am attending or submitting this quiz to my teacher. Okay, basically, so the form is showing required all the options. Okay, so now I am only selecting right answer for only one question, and for the two questions I am putting a wrong answer here. Okay, see, now I am submitting this. It is showing me view score option. See, so this is my result. Okay, and now basically I am going to my Google Drive again, from which I had created my form. Okay, so now I am again click on my form. So now it is opening from my previous email ID from which I have created my form. So see, here one response is submitted. Okay, so like this you can see your responses here, and you can download your responses from here, download responses CSV. Okay, and one more thing, go to settings. Okay, requires sign in, limit to one response. So you have to go to general setting and click limit to one response. So the person can submit the quiz only for a single time, okay, not for multiple time. One more thing you can do, you can also submitting the detail of the child. By collecting email address. Okay. Just click on the collect email address in general tab and limit to one response. Save it now. And one more field you can add in your form. Click on the section above. Click on the plus sign. So here one more field is added. Student name, and make it short answer. Okay, automatically it converted into short answer. Okay, now the form is automatically saved. So by this process you can able to make online quizzes using Google Form, and also you can see the responses, download the responses and announce the result according to the grades. Okay, one more thing you can do, you can give the particular time to your students that for an half an hour the quiz will online. So you start the link sharing at the given time and off the link sharing at the given completion time of the quiz. So after doing this, link sharing off, no one can able to access your Google form. Okay, so by this the students will give the quiz at the given particular time. No unnecessary responses will be submitting after the given time. Okay, and by this you can easily assess your students using the Google form. So if you like my video, hit the like button, click on the subscribe button for upcoming videos. Thank you. Bye bye.